Hey, welcome back once again. Summer is here, and that means barbecues, boating days, and fireworks. But much of this means fun that could be dangerous to our furry friends. Our good friend Dr. Ruth Roberts from the Sundog Cat Moon Veterinary Clinic is here with some summer safety tips for our pets. And these are some of the information that sometimes we may bypass. We might not think about it. And let's start off first with swimming in, like, the ocean for our dog.
Right, and the big...
Simple, it might seem. We see it on Sullivan. We see it at all of our barrier islands.
That's exactly it. So it's knowing kind of what your dog's accustomed to, too, is if they've not been in the ocean very often, we'll tell clients to put a halter on with a long line. So if the dog is not a strong swimmer or gets distracted, you can get them back onto shore. And then the other thing to be cognizant with the ocean is that if they're drinking the salt water, that has some very unpleasant effects at the end of the day where they might develop some pretty ugly GI stuff.
GI, but also dehydrated.
Well, exactly. Yeah. So they lose so much fluid that they become dehydrated. So it can be a very major issue. So just be cognizant of how much water, salt water, your dog is drinking, because that can cause a big issue.
And one
issue.
Of the things that you like, and I feel like John Stossel doing this interview today, it seems like a lot of times people forget, but a great thing to take with them is maybe a gallon of fresh water to rinse
exactly.
their dog off with.
Yeah. Rinse them off, and also to make sure they have plenty of fresh water to drink at the beach, because we spend so much time with our dogs other places. If we're not taking water with us and the things that they're going to need, like shade, cover, things of that nature, we can really get them into some trouble.
Yeah, got to get them some of that good water, maybe a little bit of a snack to snack on as well.
You got it.
Something that we really don't think about, because we're walking around in shoes or flops or whatever on the hot asphalt or the hot sand, we don't really realize that on those little paws, they can be tender.
They can. And actually, we've seen dogs come in where the bottoms of their foot pads are actually blistered.
Oh, gracious.
So there are all sorts of ways around this. There are great little booties you can get for your pet. They don't like them to start with, but to get them across the sand, onto the wet sand, that's a great idea. And really, for asphalt, be very cognizant to just walk off of it and use the grass, things of that nature, and that helps to protect their feet as well.
Something that we see often, and sometimes we don't realize that a dog being inside of a car with the windows rolled up, it could be actually safe for the dog in some ways, because the owner may need to do something for whatever and is leaving the engine running and the air conditioning going.
And that's it. Again, our dogs go with us everywhere. And so sometimes we have to make pit stops, whether it's for things we need or whether for things they need. So for most people that are responsible pet owners, they may leave the dog in the car with the AC running to the point where you can practically see the wind flapping the ears in the breeze. And those dogs are doing okay. That owner is going to generally be back within 10 to 15 minutes. A lot of pet owners have taken to putting up a little sign in the driver's window that says, I'm chilling. It's okay. But certainly a dog in a hot car that's not running and the windows are only cracked, that is a dangerous situation.
I actually saw a sign on Facebook that said, my dog is inside. He's okay. The air conditioning's running. He's listening to the Eagles because he doesn't like Credence. Don't bother him.
Yes, exactly.
So that's wonderful. Tell us about with folks in the backyard that have the backyard, maybe woods to the yard, reptiles, the snakes are
out there.
Along with alligators. Tell us about these snakes and our dogs.
Yeah. Well, they're happy right now because it's nice and warm, so they're free to move about. So if you've got a wooded area you back up to, just be cognizant of whether there are snakes out there. Dogs tend to get really excited about them and stick their nose in the wrong place. So it's important to kind of, if you've got that wooded area, to be out there with your pet. One of the other sort of swimming hazards in the low country is in freshwater or brackish ponds. We'll see a lot of alligators. And so that, again, you need to be cognizant of that. Generally, they're going to sun themselves on the sides of the banks. And if you're not sure, it's just best not to let your pet swim.
Got about 20 seconds left. Yep. Something that you and I were talking about right before we opened up on this segment. Peanut butter. My brother, who works out religiously every morning, will sit down after the workout and eat an apple with peanut butter, and his Bichon loves it. But there are some peanut butters that are not good for our dogs.
That's right. Some of the brands, unfortunately, have started using xylitol, which is an artificial sweetener in the peanut butter. For humans, it's kind of an upside, because xylitol actually keeps our breath fresher. But for dogs and cats, it can be toxic. So it's important to read the label. generally, if it says something like sugar-free, that's a hint that you might have an artificial sweetener present. Mm-hmm. So that would be the thing to look for there.
And you need a little sugar every now and then.
Well, it makes all life happy.
Absolutely.
Get you happy.
Dr. Ruth Roberts, tell us again where you're located.
We're on John's Island at 2908 Maybank Highway at Sundog Cat Moon Veterinary Clinic.
Wow, always a pleasure. Always thinking out of the box, too, as well. We've got more coming up in just a moment, so stay with us.